Hello there, everybody. This is Silent Mist, and I am here back in Viridian City trying to figure out what the heck I'm supposed to do. And I think, I only have a try pass? Really? How do I go to the rest of the islands? Oh yeah, I remember what I need to do. Okay, so now that we've gotten the full 160, the national decks, we need to head back up to that place where we just caught Moltres. So I'm gonna use a Max Repel, and I'll just cut out the journey there. So be back in just a moment, guys. Okay, we're back here at Mount Ember, and if we just head over to those mysterious rocket grunts that we saw a little while ago, we can talk to them, and we should be able to fight them? No? What? What do I do? Okay, silly me forgot a very simple step in this process. We need to go talk to this guy, and he's gonna be like, there's a super awesome thing. Is that right? You've caught more Pokemon. Do you know what? Maybe I can be useful to you. I'm modifying the network machine right now. I'm changing it so they can handle trades over long distances. When I get finished, you'll be able to trade Pokemon, exotic Pokemon from trainers far away. But there's a slight catch. For the link to work, the machine needs a special gemstone. It's supposed to be on one island, but I haven't found one yet. Who knows where it could be? Okay. Now that we've talked to this guy, now we go back to where those rocket goons are. So once again, be right back. Okay, we're back here at Mount Ember, and now we can find these guys. They were talking about some sort of mysterious treasure, and oh look, there's a cave here. Woo, punch to the last. Let's go treasure hunting. Any treasure we find, we haul back to the warehouse, understood? And what are the passwords? At the rocket warehouse, I mean. What, you forgot the password? There's actually two. The first one's Goldeen, need log. And the second one is, hey, Snoop, this guy's been listening in on us. You want to tell me the passwords? You've been eavesdropping? Yes, yes, we have. You see, if this were Golden Sun, I would have said, no, we have not been eavesdropping. But since this isn't Golden Sun, yep, you're going to send out a Cubone. Wow, what a riveting battle this is going to be. So let's take these guys out, and yeah. Finally, we can begin the rest of this adventure. I don't remember, like, any of this from this point on. I do know that I unlocked all 7 of the Sevii Islands, so I must have at least beaten the Elite Four once. I guess I never beat it the second time when they're significantly harder, but, nothing to worry about for now. Let's just, send out Beef to go clean up this guy and his Marowak. Are we gonna have to fight both of them, or do we only have to fight one of them, and does the other one run away? You know, I'm very hopeful that it is the latter of those two, but I have a feeling that it is not the case, and we're gonna have to fight both of them, which would be most unfortunate, to be perfectly honest, because I don't want to fight two of these guys. They're kind of butt faces. Yes, what? Nothing. Just pretend like that didn't happen. Why'd you have to win? Yeah, we gotta fight both of them. Do you have any unique Pokemon, or do I need to cut out your battle? I've been just cutting out so much that I might as well just cut out any useless battles. Oh, okay. You have a Rattata. You're leading with a Rattata. That means this battle is getting cut out. It is, it's a false swipe. It is story important, so I guess at the very least, I can give these guys the screen time that they don't deserve, but the screen time that they need. I don't know why I do this to myself sometimes. I just love to hold down the X button and not worry about a slow battle, but nope. Instead, you guys are going to go through all the suffering that I have to go through because, you know, after the last episode, after I cut out all of that training, all of that looking around for Pokemon that I haven't caught, I at least deserve this much, right? I can leave a battle in, even if it's a dumb, repetitive battle. I mean, normally I wouldn't cut out so much, but yeah, the last episode I felt was a special episode where there was just so... Why am I keeping Bagel in? There's no reason for me to train Bagel. He is not a part of my core team. If anything, I should be training, like, not Bagel, because not Bagel is at least capable of killing these guys in one hit without using a slow attack like Boomerang, or at least I should disable attack animation so I can, just quickly go through all this stuff, but nope. Silly me is doing none of that, and, I pressed the B button, not the A button. Ah, man, I am just not good at doing anything now, am I? I mean, so maybe we can get 3 hits. If we can get 3 hits, we can take this guy out in one attack. But yeah, he doesn't need any, only 2. He really doesn't need any attack or any experience because I don't plan on keeping him in my team for all too long. Considering that, he'll be used for catching Pokemon, but other than that, he doesn't have too much of a use. If I could teach False Swipe to another Pokemon, I would, but Actually, now that I think of, the more I think about it, develop amnesia conveniently and forget everything you heard. What a setback. We'll have to regroup. You, don't even think about taking a step inside of here. If you know what's good for you, and don't even think about this. Don't even think about what? I have no clue what you guys are talking about. Anything interesting inside of these rocks? Oh, we don't even have... Well, we have a Pokemon that could learn Rock Smash, but what the heck is in here? Nope, we still have the thing going on. Oh, what am I doing? I want to teach Rock Smash to a Pokemon. We have to do something about forgetting a thing. I don't even remember what thing we had to forget, and I completely forgot what the thing was. I'm just not remembering half the stuff that I'm saying. Whatever I was talking about before I went on the tangent, which I've since conveniently forgotten, it was a thing. Or maybe it wasn't a thing. I don't know what I was talking about, but let me get rid of Rage in lieu of the other thing. Oh yeah, Marowak is pretty... I'm surprised. I didn't know that he knew False Swipe. He just happened to be a really strong Pokemon that I ran into that is capable of bringing most Pokemon down to 1 HP with relative ease, assuming they're not super high level. Now, is there anything to be gained from breaking this? I doubt it, except for maybe a wild battle, which I'd rather not get into. But do we have anything interesting in here? I know there's an item that we need to get, but I don't know where that item is, so let me move... It's a strength puzzle. Nobody likes strength puzzles. They aren't Sugoi. I think usually the way I go through and do them is push stuff as few times as possible, then go do, oh, of course, one step without a repel and I get into a battle. Do push stuff as little as possible and try to push the farthest thing away. And that usually seems to be the solution to the puzzle. It's a weird one, but hey, it works out pretty well, doesn't it? Right, guys? I'm not just blatantly lying to your face, am I? No. Let's see, where is this mystical ruby thing? Can you get items from breaking these things? I don't think so. Let's see, is there a super convenient way of doing this? No, I was wondering if we could go down there and get a thing. Is there a thing over here? These divergent paths make me think that there are. I always think that there's a hidden item somewhere and then there usually isn't. So let's see, can we do anything with this? Yes, we can push this all the way over. Just gotta remember that there's another path the other way on my way back so I can check for any- What is this? Oh no! Oh no, it's Braille. I have no clue what these things say. I should figure that out because they could tell me something important. Oh, here's the ruby thing. Found a ruby. Yay. Referencing Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire. I wonder if in the other game if you get a Sapphire instead of a ruby. Yep, totally know what that says. Actually, let me go figure out what these Braille things say. I'll be right back, guys. Okay, so I have the meaning of these crazy dot things. This guy right here says, let the two glittering stones, one is red, one is blue, right? I think that says one is blue. Connect the past, or was the last one connect the past? The last one was connect the past. Two friends sharing power open a window to the new world that glows. The next world waits for you. And essentially that's just saying, yo, you can trade with Ruby and Sapphire now that you have this Ruby stone. And these ones over here say existence, oh no, cut. Does that say cut? I think that says cut. Oh Jesus, what are these? Oh God, I don't know. I thought these ones were supposed to say everything has meaning, existence has meaning, being alive has meaning, use dreams, use power. Was this dotted hole? No, this is still, oh God, dotted hole. I totally read, I spoiled. The one down there says everything has me. I don't know. I'm just looking online for these things, to be perfectly honest. Hopefully you guys aren't too sad that I just cheated for that. They don't actually mean any, I thought they were important because in Ruby and Sapphire, you needed to know what those said in order to catch the Regis, but here you really don't need to know that. It, like I said, it really doesn't affect the game at all. But there's another path this way, I think. Yes, which way do we want to go? We want to do this and that. Man, strength puzzles were so difficult for me as a child, but now they're just really, really easy. Okay, this one rock looks really suspicious. Is there something in here? Is there something of importance right here? No, it was utterly useless. It was just random nothingness. And are we just back out? Oh, we're back by the entrance. Okay. Now that we have this crystal thingamahoos, this ruby, we can go give it to Celio, and we could technically trade now with Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald versions if we wanted to. Honestly, with my current setup, that's a lot of it impossible. If I used a different emulator, I might be able to, but with VBAM, as far as I can tell, there isn't, like, multiple clients that I can set up to trade Pokemon. That, and at least as of right now, I don't have a reason to trade with Ruby Sapphire Emerald because I haven't completed the decks, but that's for future times. Oh, that's... I gave him the ruby. Yes, yes, take my ruby. And plug it in. Plug it in, plug it in. May I ask one more giant... there's another gem. Okay. On the Sevii Island, you need to go get the other gems? Okay, sure. Whatever you say. I'll go find you another gem if you really want me to, and you can complete the thing. I wonder what that other gem is. I wonder if it's possibly a sapphire. Just to allude to ruby and sapphire versions. Haha. Yeah, so I figure my plan is, for the long run, is to play through this. Then I'll probably... Oh, crap. I didn't mean to go to one island. And then probably go play through Heart Gold, Soul Silver, so I can catch... Dang it! I keep pressing A too fast, just so I can catch all the Johto Pokemon, and yeah, eventually I'll just trade everything up and we'll have every single Pokemon God knows how many years in the future. So let's go to Four Island, because we haven't been there yet, and figure out what we need to do, and I actually have no clue how long this episode's been. These longer episodes where I do a lot of cutting, it gets really hard to... Hi there, Buttface, what are you doing here? Hey, Potat, what are you doing here in the Sevii Islands? You should quit copying me, you know? Anyway, I already got my Pokemon egg, so I'm done with this Pokemon egg. Is there a breedy guy? Do we get a breedy? Okay, see you later. However many years it's gonna take, probably a bunch, but... I think I'll be able to catch every single Pokemon with some difficulty. I mean, obviously, it'll be annoying. I'll have to go to, like, Fire Red to catch a couple of Pokemon that I can't catch in this game because of those darn version exclusives, but that'll be something that we can worry about in the future. I think I'm gonna end off this video here, though. Like I said, I have no clue how long this video has been. It's either been really short or really long. Maybe it's normal length. Who knows? But yeah, that's all for now. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you all again in the next part. So until then, do you have anything that I can buy? Ultra Balls. Let's buy 10 of them, because I almost ran out when I fought the last legendary. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.